Firebase Hosting is a production-grade web content hosting. With a single command, you can quickly deploy web apps and serve both static and dynamic content to a global CDN, content delivery network. You can get started for free with a Spark plan. Besides other features, you'll get the ability to use a custom domain and a TLS certificate. In this video, we will quickly bootstrap React App using the Create React App tool and deploy it to Firebase Hosting. Then I'll show you how to add a custom domain to your web app. You can do it by creating a couple of A records. Finally, we will set up automatic builds and deploys with GitHub. When you make a change and create a pull request, GitHub Actions will build and create a preview for you that you can test before merging your code to the main branch. Alright, let's get started. There are a couple of prerequisites. First, you need a Firebase account and you need a Node.js runtime installed on your development host, including npm version 5.2 or higher. Let's run npm version to make sure that we are up to date. Then you can use npx. It's a tool intended to help round out the experience of using packages from the npm repository. It's been available in npm starting version 5.2. Create React App is another tool that can quickly get you up to speed with React. You don't need to install it separately. If it's not available locally, npx will download it first and generate React boilerplate for you. Let's call our app React Demo 85. Let's open it with Visual Studio Code. We have packages JSON to keep track of the dependencies and the React code under the source directory. This page you will see in the browser when we deploy it. Let's run it locally first to make sure it's working. When you run npm start, it will open a default browser for you. Here is our app. Next, we need to create a Firebase project. Go to the console and click Create the project. I'm going to call it the same as React App. If you have GCP organization, you can select it here. Optionally, you can use Google Analytics. You can create a new one or use default account. To deploy React App to the Firebase hosting, we need to install another npm package called Firebase Tools. Before you can use it, you need to log in with the Firebase login command. Just to check if we can access Firebase API, let's list the projects in our account. It works, we have two projects, including React Demo 85. Before we deploy React App to the Firebase hosting, we need to create an optimized production build. It will convert all the React code to HTML, JavaScript, and CSS and place it under the build directory. Let's run npm run build to do that. When we configure Firebase deploy, we will specify this folder and index.html file as an entry point to our app. You can see that it's gray out since it's added to the gitignore and we never commit these files to the git. Now let's run Firebase init hosting to initialize the project. Select use an existing project and select one that we created earlier. Instead of public, use build directory. Say yes since we're building single page React app. Skip GitHub CI/CD for now, we will come back to it a little bit later. We're done, we just need to deploy using the Firebase deploy command. If you have only hosting configured in the current folder, you can omit the rest of it. All alright, your React is deployed and you have an external URL that you can use. Let's copy it and use incognito mode in the Chrome. You can see that we can access it, and also it will have a TLS certificate, so all the connections to your web app will be secure. It has a wildcard certificate for the web app. Next, let's add a custom domain. You can host your domain anywhere, the flow will be the same, you just need to create A records. Let's enter our domain, in my case devops.example.io. If you host your domain not with Google, to verify the ownership of the domain, you would need to create a TXT record with the provided values. It's easy as creating any other records. Just enter provided key and click verify. You have to keep that TXT record, don't remove it after Firebase verify it. Then you need to create a record to point your domain to the Firebase IP address. Optionally, you can include www. It will take from 5 minutes to a couple of hours to provision a TLS certificate. Wait till it says connected and then visit the web page. Alright, it's done. Now let's go to the browser and use our domain to access the web app. The certificate is valid as well. www subdomain should work. Next, let's set up CI/CD with GitHub Actions. We need a repository first. Let's give it the same name and mark it as private. Since we already have our React locally, we need to establish connection between the local repository and remote on GitHub. Now let's commit and push our changes to the main branch. We need to reinitialize our Firebase hosting to add GitHub actions. Same build directory. Now answer yes to set up automatic builds. It will prompt you to authorize your GitHub account with Firebase. When you confirm it, it will show you a successful login page. Since we already added a remote URL, Firebase detected it and asked to confirm if you want to use that repo. Press enter. We need to run the npm build every time when there is a change. So let's say yes. Then the command to run is pretty standard npm CI to install dependencies and then build optimized production artifacts. Now if you want to get a preview each time you create a PR, which I highly recommend, answer yes. Then specify the main branch, which is called main instead of master. When you initialize the Firebase project, it will create a couple of files in the root directory. Before making any changes to the web, let's commit and push. Since we already configured CI/CD with GitHub Actions, it will run build when we push it. GitHub Actions detected the change and running deployment. Open the web app to check if there are any changes. Nope, it's the way we generated it. Now let's simulate the typical workflow for the new feature. Create a branch of main, make the change, commit and push. Just add any arbitrary change, new feature X for example. When you add files to the Git tree, you can either use a dot to indicate add all the files or use file name or directory. When we push, Git will generate a link that you can click to create a PR. Or you can do it from GitHub as well. That's our new feature. Now when you create a PR, it will run npm build and generate a preview right from the pull request tab. Let's wait a little bit. Alright, we have the link with the preview, let's open it up. This is the main web page deployed from the main branch without any changes just yet. If you open the link, you can see the text new feature X. Now to deploy this change to the devops-by-example.io, just merge the PR. After merging to the main, GitHub will rerun the same command and deploy the new version of our app with a new feature. If you go back to the devops-by-example.io and refresh the page, you will see the change. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.